Welcome to your chemistry class. I'm Dr. Morris. I'll be your instructor as we learn all about the natural world around us. Behind me, you'll notice the periodic table. Every chemistry teacher has a periodic table and they love them. I have periodic tables all over my house. My shower curtains, my sheets, obviously on my wall. Okay, they're actually just on my wall. But in any case, I do love the periodic table. The periodic table lists all of the ingredients that makes up the world around us. Every single one of those boxes represents an atom. And atoms combine together to form molecules, which we use all the time. Molecules like plastics, that's exciting. Molecules like sugar, that's delicious. And molecules like gasoline, which drive our cars. If you want to understand the world around you, you need to understand chemistry. And that's what we're going to do through the course of this class. Not only will you know more about the natural world, but hopefully you'll learn to marvel at how awesome it is. But before we do all of that, what is chemistry and what does it study? Let's take a look. First, you should know that chemistry studies matter. Matter is something that takes up space. Like these solid copper wires on these giant spools. These will eventually go into all sorts of modern technology, allowing those technologies to transfer electrons through the wires to deliver energy or to send a message. Chemistry studies liquids, like the vast ocean, full of all sorts of exotic life. It studies matter like gases, like the gas that fills this blimp and causes its density to be so low that it can fly. And actually, the gases all around it in the atmosphere, chemistry studies that as well. So chemistry studies matter, anything that takes up space. But chemistry also studies transformations or changes. Changes like those that occur during photosynthesis, where the light coming from the sun strikes these tiny leaves and it actually makes molecules. That's right, photosynthesis makes molecules. Maybe you're like, cool, why do I care about molecules? Great question, I'm glad you asked. I'm not sure if you've ever heard of sugar, it's delicious. And all the sugar you've ever eaten in your entire life has been made by plants. That's crazy, right? And every meal you eat, the only sugar there was eventually, if you trace it back, ultimately derived from plants. Photosynthesis also makes oxygen. Not sure if you've heard of that one, also pretty important. Now, of course, oxygen can be stored in these green gas cylinders that you see here, but oxygen courses through our entire atmosphere, supporting endless varieties of life, like our pets. This oxygen dissolves in the oceans, which are teeming with life, where the gills of sea creatures extract oxygen from the water. And of course, it also supports us. But what do we do with all of this oxygen? Well, shockingly, it's not unlike what's happening in this picture here, a marshmallow on fire. This fire is combining sugar in the marshmallow and oxygen in the air to burn it. And that's essentially the chemical reaction that goes on in every cell of your body. We basically take the sugar that plants make, and we take the oxygen that plants make, and we combine them back together in a process called metabolism. And metabolism makes energy. So the transformation from sugar and oxygen into energy, that's something we do all the time. This, by the way, is why we get hot when we exercise. It's because we're burning sugar. Go for a run, for example, and your body needs more energy. Your breathing increases. So you can combine ever more oxygen with more sugar, releasing more energy to move your body forward. Interestingly, this is why it's harder to run on a hot day. If you're already warm, your body won't let you burn additional sugar. It says, nope, we're hot enough. We're not going to get any warmer. That would be bad for our body. So you're just going to have to run slower, buddy. Turns out your body's really in charge. So chemistry studies matter, anything that takes up space. And chemistry studies transformations, that is changes in that matter. Chemistry also enables technology. Technology like lithium-ion batteries, which power all of our portable electronics, carrying energy with us as we go. Whether or not we're better off with these smartphones or not is a question I leave to you, dear viewer. Chemistry also enables cool things like solar cells, which are on the International Space Station, shockingly in space. This is essentially humanity's version of photosynthesis. These solar cells take in light from the sun and convert it directly into electrical energy, perhaps coursing through copper wires within the International Space Station. Chemistry also enables things like medical imaging that allows us to understand what's going on inside our body. So, chemistry studies matter, things that take up space. Chemistry studies transformations, changes in this matter, and chemistry enables technology. I hope you can see and agree that chemistry is awesome, and I hope you enjoy studying it with us. Hey, hey.